What's up, guys? Groovy Guitar Dude here with a beginner guitar trail for South of the Border by Ed Sheeran, Camila Cabello, and Cardi B. If this video helps you out, hit that like and subscribe button, and let me know down in the comments below what are the songs from any of these awesome artists that you want to learn on guitar. Guys, the first thing that you want to know to play South of the Border on guitar is that we're going to be in drop D tuning, and we are not going to need a capo to play this song. Now, if you're a beginner who's never tuned to drop D before, there's a couple of ways to get there, and it's actually a very easy tuning. We only have to change one string. The easiest way to get there is to use a tuner, and we're just going to drop our low E. We're going to loosen that until we get to a D note on our tuner. Now, if you don't have a tuner, my kind of secret little favorite trick to getting to drop D tuning quickly without a tuner is to hit your D string and hit your low E string and tune it down. Just keep going back and forth and keep tuning down until you match them. And then you're in drop D tuning. Now this is gonna take some trial and error. I have a lot of practice so I can do it quickly, obviously, but it's gonna take a little bit of practice, and you'll wanna, if you do have a tuner, that's a little bit better because you can kinda check it and just make sure you're just like right on perfect. And I do have a tuner, so I'll check mine before I do this lesson. But that is a quick little trick to getting to drop D tuning quickly, easily, and accurately if you don't have a tuner. The next thing you wanna know to play South of the Border on guitar is the structure of this song. We're gonna start out with a verse, then go to pre-chorus, then chorus, then verse, pre-chorus, chorus again, then verse, and then we're gonna finish up with one last chorus to take us out of the song. And guys, the last thing that you wanna know before we dive into South of the Border is the five chords that we need to play this song. The first one is D minor. The next one is A minor 7. The next one is C. And these next two, I'm gonna have beginner ways to play both of them in the pinned comment below. The next one from there is an A sharp. And the last one is gonna be an F. And again, for those last two, I'm gonna have beginner ways to play both of those in the pinned comment below, as well as chord charts for all the other chords for those of you who need them. And with all that in mind, guys, let's dive into South of the Border. Man, this is such a cool song. I'm so stoked for Ed Sheeran's new album. And when I heard this song, it was just like exactly the kind of song I was looking forward to being on this album. And the features in this are awesome. I love Camila and Cardi, so super, super cool. I'm really stoked to be sharing this one with you guys. So this song is a little bit tricky. It's a little bit funky. We do have that A sharp, which we don't see very much in songs. We usually try to get rid of the bar chords, but for this one, there's not a great way to get around that chord and still sound really accurate. But this is a little bit tricky, but it's very fun to play. So I would encourage anybody who's maybe a little bit intimidated by this song, don't be. Just give it a shot. We'll practice it. We'll work on it. We'll slow everything down so that we can get it down really good, and we'll work on playing it full speed. So let's dive into this. The first thing that we're going to take a look at here is what we're playing for all of our verses and all of our choruses, which is going to be most of the song. Really, the only part that's different is the pre-choruses, and we'll get to that in just a little bit. They're very, very easy. So the main part of the song is going to be the progression that's going to repeat through all of our verses and choruses. So first thing we're going to have this little picking thing that's going to lead us into this. So what we're going to do first is we're going to mute our low E string. So all you're going to do is just rest your any finger really softly on your low E string. We're going to pick, and we're going to pick again. We're going to have two muted notes. And then we're going to do a third fret on the low E, and we're going to bend it just a little bit. Just bend it just slightly. We're gonna let that go, and then that's gonna take us into our chord progression. So just a quick little time through that little picking pattern one more time. We got two muted notes, and then we bend that third low E just a little bit. Just like that, let that hang just a little bit, and then we're into our chord progression from there. From there, what we're gonna have is we're gonna have a D minor. And what we're gonna do for this, all of our strums on this are gonna be palm muted. And if you don't know what palm muting is, all you're gonna do is take the soft part of your hand that you're strumming with right here, and you're gonna rest it on your strings close to your bridge. So all of these are gonna be palm muted, but we'll kind of get to that later. I wanna show you this strumming without palm muting at first, just so you can really see a little bit more clearly what I'm doing. So first chord we're gonna have in our progression is a D minor. And what we're gonna do for that D minor is we're gonna go down, down, up, down, up, down, down, up, down, up, down, down, up. So basically it's down, down, up, twice, and then we're gonna split it in half and go down, down, up, just like that. Hopefully that made sense. One more time through that D minor progression, we're gonna go down, down, up, down, up, down, down, up, down, up, down, down, up, and then we're on to our next chord from there. Our next chord is going to be an F, and we're just going to go to this for one single down strum. Now, I know I said I was going to use or show that beginner F chord in the pinned comment below, but for this song, I am actually playing the beginner F chord because we are in drop D. It doesn't really work to play our full normal F chord shape, and I think it actually sounds better to play the beginner F chord. So if you've never seen this, this is what it looks like. It's a first on B, second on G, third on D, and that's what I'm going to be playing for this song. So again, we're going to have a single down strum on that F chord, and then we're going to be very quickly into the A sharp chord. This is going to be the hardest part of the song, is making this transition here. We're going to go very quickly to that A sharp, and we're going to do an up strum on that, and then we're going to go to our A minor 7, and we're going to do a down, let that down hang for just a second, and we're going to go up, down, up, down. And that's it. That's the whole progression with all the strum patterns that's going to repeat. I know that seems super intimidating. It is definitely a little bit challenging. It's definitely going to take some practice. It took me some practice for sure. So what we're going to do is we're going to walk through that one more time slowly, and then we're going to play through it a couple times slowly, and then we'll work our way up to full speed. So one more time walking through that whole progression, that whole pattern that's going to repeat through all of our verses and choruses will look like this. We're going to start here with our two muted notes on the low E. We're going to hit muted, muted, and then we're going to do a third fret on the low E, bend just a little bit, and then we're going to go to our D minor, and for our D minor, we've got down, down, up, down, up, down, down, up, down, up, down, down, up, and then to our F chord, we're going to do a down strum, and then very quickly to our A sharp, up strum, and then quickly to our A minor 7, and we've got down, let that first down hang, and then up, down, up, down. And that is just going to repeat through all of our choruses and all of our verses. Like I said, guys, pretty tricky. Best way to get this thing down, and really anything complicated on guitar like this, is just to start by playing it very slowly, get it right first, and then work up your way with your speed to full speed with the song as you get it down. That's exactly what I did with this song. It's exactly what I do with all the songs that are a little bit tricky like this one. So guys, a couple of times slowly through that progression with all of that, a couple times through that slowly so that we can make sure that we have all the right stuff in all the right places, will look about like this. And guys, a couple of times full speed through the guitar part that we're going to repeat through all of the verses and choruses for South of the Border, so most of the song, full speed will look about like this. And guys, the only other thing that you need to know to play South of the Border is the pre-choruses. And the pre-choruses are much, much easier than the verses and choruses. So I know you guys will be happy to hear about that. For the pre-choruses, we're going to start with an A sharp. We're going to have two down strums, not palm muted or anything. We're just going to go down, down. And then we're going to go to an F chord, and we're going to do a single down strum for that one. Let that hang for just a second. And then we go to a C chord. We're going to have two down strums for that one. We're going to go down, down. And we go to D minor, single down strum for that one. And then we're going to kind of loop back around and almost repeat this with one change. We're going to go back to that A sharp. We're going to go down, down, and then to F, single down strum for that one, down. And then we're going to go to C, and for C, this time we're going to do three down strums. We're going to go down, down, down. And that's it. That's just going to play once through for each of our pre-choruses. So one more little walkthrough of that. We start with an A sharp there. We're going to go two down strums there. Down, down, and we go to our F with a single down strum. Down. And then we go to C. We've got two down strums there. We're going to go down, down, then D minor, single down strum, down. And then we go loop back around to that A sharp, down, down, and then F, down. And then we go to our C and then three down strums on that one, down, down, down. And then we're into our choruses from there. So guys, with this one, pretty simple, pretty straightforward. Just kind of got to remember which strums go where or which amount of down strums go where, rather. But for this one, again, this is kind of one of those places where we're only going to play this once for each pre-chorus. But to make sure that you guys can kind of get it and kind of jam and practice on this, I'm going to go ahead and play through it a couple of times and loop it through a couple of times so you can get the idea of it. So guys, a couple of times through the chord progression and strum pattern that we're going to repeat for our pre-choruses will look about like this. And guys, that is everything that you need to know to play South of the Border on guitar. As always, if you have any questions, you can hit me up in the comments down below. I'm usually pretty quick getting back to those. And again, if this video helped you out, hit that subscribe button. I have about 700 other guitar and ukulele lessons on this channel, and I usually try to post at least 3 to 5 new lessons every single week. So if you're learning guitar or ukulele, there could not be a more perfect channel for you to check out. If you want to see what song I'm jamming on today or pictures of my dog, you can hit up my Instagram story at the Groovy Guitar Dude. Link for that will be in the description below. Wow, guys, what an awesome collaboration from an awesome group of artists. I love all of these artists individually, so seeing them come together and make this super cool song is just great. I love it. I've been listening to it all day. It just came out. Well, you guys will be seeing this on Saturday. It just came out yesterday or today for me, and it's just a great song. I love it. It's such a cool vibe. I love how Ed Sheeran really intentionally incorporated some of the kind of like some of Camila's vibe, and that's awesome. And I saw an interview that they just posted for me again a few hours ago. I saw an interview they posted, and it was very intentional that they kind of just added a lot of Camila's vibe into this, and I love that. It's just a great song. It's really, really cool, and it's a really great group of artists. The guitar for this song is a little bit more tricky than most of the stuff that I usually post. This is a little bit more of an intermediate level song because you do have some bar chords in there. It is in a different tuning, things like that, fast transitions, all of those types of things. But if you're a beginner, don't be discouraged. This is actually a great song to work into some of those things, work into those fast transitions, learn those bar chords. And again, I do have beginner versions of those bar chords in the pinned comment below if you need kind of an alternate version. And I do understand that A sharp is tricky, man. That's kind of got my fingers hurting a little bit too because I've been playing it so much today. So this is a great song. It's so fun to play. Like I said, it is a little bit tricky, but it does repeat the same thing over and over again for most of the song. So at least you don't have to like really kind of remember a bunch of different moving parts. It's really just that one part throughout most of the song and then your pre-choruses. So beautiful song, guys. So fun to play. I had a lot of fun learning this song. I hope you guys have a lot of fun learning it as well. And I hope you have a wonderful day. I'll see y'all soon.